Hi and welcome to my second video in the series about structure and bonding, and today we're going to look at electron structure. Okay, so today we're going to look how electrons are structured within the atom. And we're going to use the example of an atom of potassium. So looking at potassium, we can tell here, because it's got a proton and an atomic number of 19, that tells us that it has 19 protons. It also tells us it has 19 electrons. And in this case, it has 20 neutrons, because 20 plus 19 gives us our 39. Now, electrons are arranged in sections called shells. Now, anything I tell you on this video is probably relative to a GCSE qualification. In reality, it's much, much more complicated than this. But for the purposes of your exam and for the purposes of your revision, we'll run with what's on a specification. Okay, so this represents our atom of potassium. And you can see in the middle here, it's got our nucleus. And the nucleus contains the protons and the neutrons, and they're the parts of the atom that contain the mass. And then you've got these shells of electrons whizzing around the outside. Now, the distance, in reality, if the distance between the nucleus and the electrons is vast, a good equivalent might be is if you had a golf ball representing a nucleus and put it on the centre spot of Wembley, then the electrons would be whizzing around outside at the stadium. Now, the pattern for electron structure within their shells is always the same. It's always a maximum of 2 in the first shell, and then a maximum of 8 in the next, and then 8 in the next, and then 8 in the next. And so this pattern rings true for all atoms found in the periodic table. So in this case, there would be 2 in its first shell, there'd be 8 in its next shell, and there'd be 8 within the third shell, and then the final shell, there'd be 1 left over. And if we count up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And that totals the number of electrons found within potassium. Now, Mendeleev, this guy at the top right here, is a very, very important person in science because he formulated the first periodic table. And what he did was he began to put the different elements into groups and into basically a pattern that we could try to understand. The way in which he's divided the periodic table is he's divided it first of all into two sections, into groups which run down the table and periods which go across. Now, the vertical columns, which are groups, they indicate elements which have very, very similar properties to one another. So if it's within the same group, it has a very similar property to all elements found within that group. If we were to start with this element here, so this one is hydrogen and this one here is helium, and work our way across and then down and across and keeping going like this, then that pattern there shows the ascending proton or atomic number. And so they get slowly larger. So hydrogen has a proton number of 1, helium 2, lithium 3, beryllium 4, boron 5, carbon 6, and so on and so forth. And so they're organised into ascending number or ascending proton number. Now, looking at groups specifically, we can see how the groups are arranged on the periodic table. So this section here, that's group 1. Starting with beryllium and magnesium and calcium here, that's group 2. Now we jump to group 3 from here, so to boron. So this is group 3 here, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you've probably got, or you've seen a labelled periodic table diagram, and there are 8 major groups. This section in here are called the transition metals, and we won't really be dealing with those today. But looking at the groups, we can all tell, if it's specifically in group 1, we can tell how many electrons it has in its outer shell. So, for example, if it's in group 1, it has 1 electron in its outer shell. If it's group 2, 2 electrons. If it's group 3, 3. If it's group 4, 4, and so on and so forth. The group on the end here, group 8, has a full outer shell, and it has 8 electrons in its outer shell. So in summary, the electrons found within atoms are arranged in shells. The shells have a capacity, so each shell, the first shell has a maximum of 2 electrons in it, the second shell 8, the third shell 8, and the fourth shell 8. The groups, they run down the periodic table, so anything within a vertical group has very, very similar properties to one another. So for instance, lithium and sodium are very, very similar in their properties. And the group number determines the number of electrons within its outer shell. So an example of this would be lithium being in group 1 has 1 in its outer shell, magnesium being in group 2 has 2, and something like aluminium being in group 3 has 3 in its outer shell. And there are 8 groups in total found on the periodic table.